In this clip, we're going to paint the remaining metal parts of the gramophone. So the first thing that you will notice is that I went between clips and bring in our normal map to have these lines of the cone. So the procedure I follow was exactly the same one as I did with the plate on clip 4. So I will just jump that and I will just start painting and bringing in some materials. So the first thing I want to do is basically turn off all the objects that has been applied materials already. So I will just hide all of these texture sets and I will keep these three that you're seeing. So I will start with the 10-11. So let me hit F on my keyboard and frame that a little better and rotate our camera. And let's go to our layers. And what I want to do here is basically go to our shelf, pick our smart materials, and I will go and type here on our search box for the silver armor. So I will drop that one there, and this is going to be the first layer. And then in top of this, I will clean our search box and type gun. And I will use this steel gun painted. So I will just drag that one there. And as you can tell, this is creating this painted metal black part. And I want to mask this so we add a little bit of a story. So now I create a mask in order to do that, and I will add a generator. With this generator, what I want to do is go to our properties tab and pick the dirt generator. So as you can tell, it's fairly working. However, what I want to do here is basically invert, so we keep more or most of the painted area revealed instead of the silver. And there you go. Now I will go and pick the 10-02 texture set, and I will just drag a basic bronze armor for now. So I will just clean this here, and I will drag this bronze armor, our favorite for these metal parts, or at least my favorite. And there you go. This is working quite well. So now we have applied those two materials. I will go and work on the cone part. So I will go to our texture set, and then I will go to 10-12 texture set, and I will go to our layers. Then I will start bringing in a copper worn, and in this copper worn, as you can tell, is working quite well. It's giving a little bit of the reddish tintish that these cones has against this chromish metal part or this bronze metal part. So that's working quite well. Then I want to modify a couple things here. So let me just pick a better angle here, and then I will turn off this dirt layer, and I will go to the worn surface layer. I will pick the mask, and I will basically get rid of this generator. I want to bring in my own new generator. So I will add a new generator, and on this new generator, I will go to our property tab, and I will add a dirt generator. All right, so now that we have this dirt generator, what I want to do is increase the dirt level, so we have a little bit more of dirtiness, and then decrease the dirt contrast a little bit so it feels a little bit more subtle. As you can tell, this is feeling really solid. I will just bring in this dirt layer on top of it and close our layer here. Then what I want to do is go to our shelf, and I will drag a bronze armor on top of this. So with this bronze armor, obviously this is getting rid of the previous work that we did with the copper worn. So what I want to do is tweak this a little bit. The first thing I want to do is go to the blending modes, and for the color channel that is already selected here, I will go and disable the color. So we bring back our reddish color. Then for the roughness, I want to have a little bit of the blending of both of the roughness. So I will go here to our blending modes, and I will change these to a screen. So let me just look for the screen, and there you go. So now this is feeling quite cool to me. It is feeling really organic. But what I want to do next is add a little bit of rustiness, because what happened with these metal parts, when they get rusty and when they get oxidated, what happened is that the color start to change to a pseudo green or a kind of green. So that's exactly what happened, for instance, with the Statue of the Liberty. That's why it is green. So in order to do that, what I will do is basically bring this bronze statue material, because we know that this is going to give us that exact result. And as you can tell, it's working pretty well. However, I want to mask this. I don't want to have this and ruin the work that we did between the bronze armor and the copper one. So in order to do that, what I want to do is add a mask. And between this mask or in this mask, I will basically add a generator. And then I will go to our property tab and then pick the same dirt generator. So as you can tell, this is working quite well. So I will increase the dirt level. So I want to make it a little bit dirtier. And then the dirt contrast is going to get down. And actually, we could get down a little bit off the dirt level. I went too far. And as you can tell, the edges, especially outside of our cone, is working quite well. This is working like a rusty copper material. Now that we have that, let me go back to our base color. And I will hit Command C on my keyboard. And I will copy that specific layer. Then I will go to the other texture sets. So I will just basically go here and paste this in top. So we bring in a little bit of that. So in this particular case, I will basically decrease it, first of all, a little bit. So it's not that much in all the object because that's not something that we want. And then I will increase the contrast and decrease the wear level a little bit. So it's a little bit more focalized or localized. Then let's go back to our texture set list again. And I will go to the 10.02, which is going to be this part here. And then I will paste our same crossed layer. And as you can tell, it's working really well. You can feel it in these areas here that is connecting and it's been rust based on that. So then I want to basically increase the contrast and decrease the level a little bit so it feels more localized again as we did with this other piece. So now that we have this, this should be ready to be exported. So let me go to our texture set list and then I will basically bring back all of our objects and make sure that everything is working together. So as you can tell, we have a lot of details on these textures and a lot of different procedures to work with this Gramophone. So the last step is going to be export the textures or prepare the preset to export our textures because this is a UDIM object. So I will hit Shift Command E on my keyboard and this will bring the export document window. Here, what I want to do is go to our renderman. I already created one, so I will just delete this one here so we can know how we can create this preset. I will pick this renderman preset or configuration and then I will duplicate it and then I will change the name to renderman UDIM because the actual naming of the channels or the texture set has to be a little bit different. So the thing that you have to keep in mind, and let me just get rid of that, is that you want to keep your channel and then a dot and then your texture set, which is going to be associated to the 10.001, 10.002, and so on. So in order to do that, what I will do is get, as you can see, get rid of the name. I will add a dot and add a texture set. So this is the structure or the way that we have to name our textures. So now that we have this, I will pause the video for a sec and change the name for all of them because you don't need to see me doing that in several occasions. So I will come back as soon as I do that. So now that I changed the name for all of our texture sets or channels, I will go back to our export tab and then we'll enable all of our texture set. Now that I have enabled all of our texture sets, I will change the configuration to our renderman UDIM. And as you can tell, it has applied the name of the channel, then a dot, and then the texture set. And this is the number that will drive our UDIM when we apply this on renderman and Maya. So now I will pick my extension to be TIFF and our bits to be 32 float bits so we work linear as we have been doing it for the other objects. And then I will change the path to be exported these textures. So I will go to Maya files, source images, and then to the Gramophone texture folder. I will hit open and this will link that texture and then hit export and come back when the texture has been exported. All right, so all of our texture has been exported and you can check on the color all the UDIMs for this object and this is working pretty solid. So let me go back to Substance Painter. As you can tell, we had a lot of story here, a lot of details on the textures again, and we should be able now in the next model to start putting together all of the objects that we have painted so far.